Hi everyone, welcome to today's session. So okay, we're going to talk about career in trademark litigation today. So let's get started. All right, so career in trademark. So, you know, we hear a lot of this that people say, what do you want to do when you graduate? And people say, I want to be an IP lawyer. So what is an IP lawyer? What do IP lawyers do? Right, and that's an important question, because it seems that many people make their decisions on what they are going to do based on their initial experience of studying IP law in college. So people make a decision that they want to do IP law based on a fascination that they might develop during studying IP law in one or two semesters in college. And they assume that if they like reading the sections or the case laws or the issues seem interesting and fascinating, they're going to like working in IP law, which is not always true. Okay, why I say that is because when you are actually doing the work of IP law, it is not necessary that you just deal with simple issues of like what. You don't deal with the concepts. There's a lot of paperwork involved, and you have to understand the work that IP lawyers get paid for. Because if you don't understand that, you might have a misconception about what it is all about, and that leads to a lot of problems. So, interestingly, in India, when you talk about doing IP law, most of it is related to trademark. I guess because majority of work that lawyers are currently working on gets registered. All the contracts that get drawn up are all related to trademark. Okay? There is copyright and patent as well, but compared to trademark, the size of those matters and the volume of those matters, to be precise, is much less. Okay? Trademark is registered in a massive volume, and the number of people who are working on trademark among IP lawyers is also very, very large. Okay, so let's first understand what kind of work do IP lawyers do. So primarily there are four types of work. Okay, three types but one additional, four types of work. What would this work involve? One work that you do is simply related to registration of IP. It could be any kind of IP, but when you are doing registration and filing, that is one sort of work that lawyers get paid for. So in case of trademark, that is trademark registry. Okay, registering trademark is something that that lawyers do and get paid for. I'll tell about how that has changed over time. But the second kind of work that is involved is basically contracts related to IP, which is licensing, assignment, agreements and all of that. Sometimes that also involves due diligence, right? Before doing a contract, you might do some sort of a due diligence on the IP. So that is one thing. And then finally, you have the third type of work, which is disputes. So whenever there is any kind of dispute over any IP, there would be some sort of, it could be that either you are enforcing an IP by prosecuting somebody who is infringing on the IP. It could be that there are two people or two different parties are arguing over who owns the IP, or it could be that you are rejected, your application for registration of IP or rejected, and there is some objection or some kind of opposition. Okay, in which both of which cases you have to, those are also considered disputes. Now, the fourth type of work is basically monitoring services, that has portfolio management and monitoring services that has really become very important for law firms and IP lawyers. Major area there is basically, let's say there's a company with a lot of, and the IP may be infringed on in any given country or any different places or different states. There may be counterfeiting, there may be violation of copyright or patent or trademark. So how do companies deal with that? They basically have law firms providing a monitoring service to them. So monitoring service is essentially that, they will keep an eye for any kind of infringement, and whenever they find an infringement, they will sue that. They will file, you know, send notices and file cases and take it to the court and all of that. Now, when all of that happens, the law firm makes money. Of course, it's a dispute eventually. But monitoring service is a unique kind of service altogether that firms provide and make a lot of money from. Okay. Now, these are the four types of work. Now, let's come to specifically to trademark. So, what happened in trademark over the last few years, that initially, you know, trademark registration was a highly profitable area. You could literally charge 1 lakh rupees for registering one trademark, right? MNC coming into India, registering trademark, they would want the trademark registered in different classes and the logos and the words separately and all of that. Naturally, you could make a lot of money from IP, from trademark registration. But it has not remained so. Over the years, there are a lot of players providing trademark registration services, and you have even, you know, people, if you could charge 1 lakh once upon a time, now there are people ready to do a trademark registration for 2,000, 4,000, 5,000. And basically, trademark registration has not remained expensive. So many people are registering, there are a lot of marks getting registered, but there are these almost like, you know, factories or sweatshops where people are registering lots of trademarks every day at a very low cost. As a result of which, registering trademark has not remained an attractive business for law firms, okay, or for lawyers for that matter. The margins are very less. The margins are very low for registering a trademark, okay. So in a way, law firms had to kind of shift towards other work and other work. Let's specifically talk about contracts. So licensing agreements, franchise agreements, assignment agreements, technology transfer agreements, all sorts of, you know, IP assignment agreements and IP related agreements. They were quite a moneymaker for lawyers and law firms for a while. There was a time, you know, in India, maybe even 15 years back, only maybe 4 or 5 law firms could specialize in that kind of contract. It was very hard to find people who could work on specialized IP contracts, let's say back in 2005 or 2006. And those lawyers who knew how to work on IP contracts made a lot of money. A lot of money in the sense they could earn lakhs for, you know, doing a transfer of, you know, assigned or IP assignment or licensing agreement. Now, compared to that, today you cannot charge that much, and there are a lot of lawyers, a lot of law firms, everybody is ready to do that work. As a result of which, whenever the supply of a certain service increases in the market, naturally the price has fallen a great deal. Okay, for you can still charge a good money, like, you know, 15,000, 20,000 or 50,000 also for drafting an IP related agreement, depending on who is the client, what's the sensitivity of the matter, and all of that. But in the end of the day, it's not as attractive as it used to be. And you now have, like, more or less the price is being driven down in the market in these areas also, as contracts become more and more easier to draft. Especially there has been a lot of in-house teams. So companies who used to pay outside lawyers earlier to draft these contracts, they prefer to hire in-house counsels and get it drafted. So if you want to media and IP, like, so, you know, trademark definitely is very important for multiple industries, starting from manufacturing, retail, to any sort of consumer facing companies. Trademark is very, very critical, but at the same time, companies are hiring their in-house lawyers, and they find it to be more cost effective and reliable than going to outside lawyers for routine work, especially if it is routine work like drafting contracts or registering of IP or even monitoring services sometimes. Now, what's happening is that while these two areas of work has been going down for trademark lawyers who independently want to practice trademark law, litigation has been growing more than ever. So because there's the low cost of IP agreements and IP registration, trademark registration, there is a explosion of number of trademarks being registered. It is incredible to find that even, like, you know, the neighborhood shops have started registering their trademark. Okay, like somebody opens a, let's say, I don't know, a Momo stall, and they'll also go and get trademark registration done. That has become the common thing in India for businesses to register trademark, which was not the case earlier. And the fact that there is a low cost of registration has helped towards that a great deal. Now, what's happening as a result of all of this is that there is an increasing number of disputes that are coming up, of agreements are on increasing number of disputes have really gone up, and trademark disputes is expected to explode in India in the coming years. And the reason for that is simple, that there are so many trademarks. We never had as many trademarks as we have today, and people are very serious about their intellectual property. Unlike the Indian business scenario, first of all, India did not have too many businesses which were conscious about their intellectual property, not even formal businesses for that matter. Suddenly you have a lot of businesses which are extremely serious about their IP, and they are working really hard towards protecting their IP, and they really value their IP. So that has led to already an explosion of trademark disputes and trademark cases, and it's going to happen more and more in the coming years. It's just a matter of time. Okay. So this is how it is, and that is why trademark litigation is such an attractive area of work today. And most of the many law firms, IP law firms, once upon a time did not even have their own trademark dispute team in the past. But now everybody has a trademark litigation team. There is no IP law firm that does not have a trademark litigation team. In fact, the trademark litigation team is increasing in size continuously, and that is one area where they are very happy to hire new lawyers. That is one area where companies are also happy to hire lawyers. It is becoming more and more attractive, and it's likely to be even attractive in the next few decades, I would say, at least that as far as I can see. So this is the initial introduction, guys. If you have any question at this point, what do you want to know about trademark litigation? So all of you are here, I'm sure you have some questions about trademark litigation. What are your questions? Please type in the chat. There are no questions. So I'll continue for a little more, and I'll tell you what I want to share about trademark litigation. So in trademark litigation, the very important skill is, there are a few things. One part in IP litigation is about evidence collection, which is kind of difficult and very, very important. Much of the success of the case depends on your ability to collect evidences, because even if there has been certain violation of trademark, or even if you're claiming that your trademark is, you are the rightful owner of the trademark, or you've been using it for a long time, the challenge is in collecting evidence and showing it. And there are even organizations which work towards that. There are firms, there are investigation services that focus entirely on collection of evidence in trademark matters. Okay, we have a few questions. Let's take a look. How and what to do as a law student if we do have interests in IP law, except internships and online courses? Okay, that's an interesting question. So, of course, the whole idea is to learn the work. Okay, learn the work. If you learn the work, you'll get a job. Okay, so there are a few things. Learn the work and build a network to demonstrate. A network of people to whom you can demonstrate that you know the work. That will lead to clients, that will lead to jobs. Even if you're a law student, you can start by writing articles around trademark. Not the entire IP law, I would say start with trademarks. And if you start writing about trademarks, you'll be able to build a track record of knowledge in trademark law, and that you will be able to demonstrate that you have been interested in the subject for a while. And also, when you write articles and publish, you get knowledge in those specific things that you're writing about, which will be a little much more than what people just learn from college. So that goes a long way. Online courses, just doing any online course does not help. You have to do a course where you will be learning the practical skills that you can actually demonstrate during an internship. So if you go to an IP law firm, okay, and you are able to do work that associates are already doing over there, right? So for example, one very important thing to learn in trademark litigation will be how to file documents, right? How to file it in the court. Many of the IP law work happens in the high court, where you go for an injunction. You have to get an injunction, right? So how do you prepare your case? How do you prepare your file? How do you deal with the registry, right? When you go to the high court registry and file a case, how do you deal with them, right? Because, what would lead to defects in filing, and then how do you cure those defects? These are very important things to learn. And if you can show them that you're useful and you know these things as an intern, right? You can help them in preparing the files. You can help in preparing, you know, these are more basic things, but if you can help them with those things, it will be highly valuable for them. And it would lead to your internship being converted into a job offer. Okay. But basically, focus on understanding the work that lawyers are doing in the law firm. Okay. And learn how to do the same work. Because if you can show them that you already know the work and they don't need to spend a lot of time to think, you can, best reason you can give to anybody to hire you. Because when they need a lawyer, they don't want to train somebody for 3 months, 6 months, 1 year. It's just frustrating for them. But if you already know the work and you show promise that you can do it with diligence, then that's a great reason to hire you. Okay, let's see another question. We have a question. It seems patent litigation is quite complex for lawyers with no engineering background. What about trademark and copyright litigation? How to start practice in such niche areas? Patent litigation is complex. All litigation is complex. Patent litigation involves, scientific facts. So if you don't understand science, if you don't, what is the situation with the, the disclosure, whatever invention is being disclosed, if that is actually unique or not, if there's actually inventive steps involved in that, that requires you to spend some time understanding the scientific position on that. If you basically, let me put it this way, if you're not somebody who can read a scientific article and understand the crux of it, you should not really try to do patent litigation. In terms of copyright and trademark litigation, why not? I mean, those are also complex, but at the same time, it's like any other litigation. And how to get started? Sumit, what's your background, if you can tell me? I mean, what do you do? Are you a law student? Let's say I already answered the law student question. Let me talk about lawyers. So if you're a lawyer doing some other kind of litigation and you want to get into IP litigation, so that's a little bit of challenge, because IP litigation is seen as a very niche thing and people go to expert IP lawyers and not to others. Okay. So if you want to start by doing that, you have to first build a track record in trademark litigation. And how you can do that is, as a lawyer, you might already have certain clients. So you can start educating them about their trademark, about trademark infringement, etc. And you can, if you talk to your clients or you send them newsletters about your IP matters, then soon they might approach you for some advice, some ideas, some things. So that is one way to build and get into it. You obviously, when you're starting out in IP, you might have to kind of figure out, give people incentive to bring you cases which they might not have prosecuted. A lot of times there are infringements, there are other things that people, businessmen, do not prosecute because they don't want the headache, they don't want to spend money on it. But if you can be there and you can promise them that without much headache you can take care of it initially, then they would be open to giving you such opportunities. And once you have done a few matters like that, then you can start, and you get to understand also what is the complexity involved and what it is that you like to do or not, and whether it is getting you enough margin or not. At that time you can start a full-fledged business development operations geared towards getting more IP cases. And that's very much possible, because there's a lot of work out there. A lot of work out there with respect to trademark at least. Okay, let me see the next question. Is LLM from a foreign university important or necessary to pursue a career in trademark law? Absolutely not. So if you have an LLM, it's not like you'll get paid more, or, there's one benefit though of doing an LLM, that foreign clients, if you've done an LLM from a good university abroad, then foreign clients might be more interested in giving you the work, because they feel that you might be knowing the laws of their own country better, or they might just feel a certain comfort, right? So imagine that you had to hire a lawyer in Bangladesh for some reason. If they have studied in a college that we know in India, then it might give you certain confidence that, okay, this lawyer might be, better to work with as far as we are concerned. So that's the only advantage I see. If Kartabhya asking a question, scope of trademark litigation in small city like Indore how to explore internship. Trademark litigation in small city like Indore, Indore is not a small city, but even in smaller cities, extremely good, because see, trademark litigation just does not happen in big cities. It happens in smaller cities a lot of times because the counterfeiting is happening there also, right? So if in, let's say there is somebody selling fake medicine or fake branded t-shirt or whatever, right? You know, something infringement is happening in Indore, which is very likely to happen because it's a significantly big market. So then the lawyers in Bombay or Delhi would need support of the lawyers in Indore to file cases there, to conduct raids over there, to get any kind of work done over there, right? They will need that help, and that help you can provide because you are in Indore, and it cannot be done by anybody who is not located in a place like that. Okay. If some notorious guy asking money in name of a registered private limited company, not exactly as the name registered in ROC, is there anything to worry for a company suffering? Yes, go file a police complaint with your company, you know, protect your company, go file a police complaint against the guy so that tomorrow if there's anybody comes trying to sue you or any kind of allegations, you can prove that you have taken all reasonable steps to prevent that from happening. Okay, next question. I have analyzed myself by observing 3 months daily attending courts in IP and sometimes arbitration. Is it good to focus only on your interest area as a law student? Absolutely. Ruthlessly focus on your interest area, because people will tell you that, you know, if you need to learn everything, how do you know, blah, blah, blah. But the truth is that it is really hard to get a break into the legal industry, okay? And if you focus on one area, then you're likely to have more knowledge in that area, more advantage in that area, and you're likely to get your first break. Once you get your first break and you start having money and clients and jobs, then I would encourage you to go and learn more. But, you know, most people get lost. They never make that first break, that first success where, you know, you have a job, you have learned something well, one thing at least well, and you have that, you know, you have then the luxury to go and learn everything else if you like. But if you do not start with that, if you do not, you learn a lot of different things, but you're not getting a job, how does that help, right? It does not help. And getting a job, your chances of getting a job is much higher. For example, if you are really good at IP and other people know everything, but not that as good as you in IP, then an IP law firm will hire you, not the other person, who also knows M&A and also have done 5 different internships in 5 different areas, knows some criminal law. Nobody says, wow, you are so well-rounded, you know different things, let me hire you. They'll hire you because you are so good at the work that they have to do. In the end of the day, a law firm or a business, everybody is running a business and they want to see how you can help them. So if you're really good at just trademark litigation or just anything at all, in one thing, then that's a good enough reason for them to hire you. Okay. Rohit is asking, can you name some top IP firms in India for trademark litigation? All the usual suspects. Anand and Anand is really famous. You have Sai Krishna and Associates. You have Zeus IP. There are so many law firms, right, who are doing work in the area of trademark litigation. All the good IP law firms, all the top IP law firms. How some advocate in traditional field can make transition to company law related fields. I can talk about IP today. I'll not talk about company law. Only IP, trademark. Gaurav, I have interest in IP litigation. Great Gaurav, pursue it. Kartavya, thanks sir, but clear place of right internship. Clear place of right internship. Anybody has work, you can. So one idea that I can give you, apart from working in internships in law firms. Of course, litigators who are doing a lot of IP related litigation, one thing that you can do perhaps is find companies which have large IP portfolios and intern there, because working with a company gives you a great insight into how clients think, because most people know how lawyers think and how lawyers operate, but they are quite blind to what clients want. And by working with the client, you learn what a client wants, which is a great asset for a lawyer. That I can strongly recommend. In early years, go and somehow get attached with a company which has enough intellectual property and start helping them with IP matters. That would go a long way. Shubham Kumar. I have only been working independently in filing registration application for fresh trademarks and replying to examination reports, but now I want to explore more. How can I gain experience in trademark litigation, as local vendors usually don't prefer to go for litigation? That's true. See, people will only go for litigation when there's enough money at stake. So if they're, you need to find people, you know, who are, for whom it's a big deal. So even if you're working for local vendors who do not want to go for litigation, you can do one or two for free, just like that. You know, like, don't even charge money, just do it for them to gain the experience, because you want to get started. So tomorrow, if you go for another client who actually has a paid matter to give you, and you can give them 2-3 examples of matters that you have, you don't need to tell them that you did it for free, but you can tell them, give them examples of matters that you've done before, there's a much higher chances of you landing that job, because they're not going to give you, nobody wants to give work to a lawyer for the first time, right? So your first few experiences must come somehow, even at a low cost, even at free, whatever is possible. As long as you have some experiences, you might be okay. Next question, Sumit. Is there any leak in other IP like brands, goodwill, geographical indicators, planned variety, share and company valuation is not IP. I'll talk about brands, goodwill. Okay. Yeah, brands is trademark. Goodwill, there's nothing. Geographical indicators, very little work. Not much at all. Planned variety, I've never heard of a planned variety case in my life. I'm sure it exists somewhere to some people. Not seen one. No, I mean, trademark is major. Copyright is okay. Patent is very less but very profitable. There's very few patent matters in India but very profitable. That's why it's worth looking at. Otherwise, focus on things that are obviously big enough and there's enough work. Is a foreign LLM necessary for promotion as senior associate partner in Indian IP law firm? No, absolutely not. Okay. Foreign LLM is not necessary for promotion as senior associate or partner in Indian law firms. They won't give a damn if you have a foreign LLM, okay? They don't care. They only care about the work, you can do it or not. If you do go and do an LLM, it'll be like for your own purpose. Don't do it because it'll help you to get more salary, or it won't. Gaurav, I'm thinking of joining IP law firm. Is it good to start for the person who wants to go in IP litigation, or should join an IP lawyer counsel? Start with an IP law firm. Better, much better. IP law firms do not argue maybe in the court, but they do everything else. You learn everything. If you want to be an arguing counsel, it's possible. But it's just, I would say, like, it's harder in terms of you do not start with much payment and you struggle initially, but it's worth it. If money is not an issue, you can definitely try doing that. You can go and work with a arguing counsel, right? Like, Amit Sibal is a famous arguing counsel in Delhi in IP matters. So maybe you can get an internship with somebody like that. That's also possible. Okay, guys, any other questions? If there's no other questions, I'm actually going to wrap up, because there's not much more to discuss in trademark litigation itself. Basically, trademark litigation, I want to tell you that trademark litigation is an extremely lucrative area of practice in the years to come. Nothing happens overnight, okay? You have to spend your 1 or 2 or 3 years. You have to learn as much as you can, as fast as you can. And after that, if you stick to it, this is one of the golden areas of practice in the years to come, okay? Monitoring services. Okay, I'll give you an example. So there's a law firm that monitors all of, BCCI hires this law firm to make sure that nobody is unauthorizedly using any of their intellectual property, so that they can charge a lot of money from the real people who are paying for the licensing fees, right? So for example, let's say if there's a lot of value for Indian cricket team jerseys, people want to buy Indian cricket team jerseys. Now, if Indian cricket team jerseys are being sold in markets randomly here and there, and no license fee is being paid to BCCI for the same, then BCCI is losing out a lot of money. So what happens is that BCCI hires a law firm and says that you can, anytime you can find anybody who's infringing on this particular right and you sue them, you take them to court, we'll pay you 10 lakhs to 10 lakhs rupees every time you can do that. Okay. So this law firm will now hire investigators, will hire local councils, etc. And even would have tie-ups with police also sometimes. And they will conduct raids, they will collect evidence. So they find out that, okay, in this particular market in XYZ place, there is some infringement going on. Like, you know, people are selling Indian in jerseys. So they'll find that, collect evidence, conduct raids, get court orders, and then arrest people, do whatever it takes. But the point is that they will get paid every time they do this. Sometimes they get money even from sending a notice. Okay, so they have a blanket authorization that every time they see this violation. So this is a monitoring service. Okay, I hope that helps. Any other question, anybody? Sumit, is that a? Did you understand what I said? Monitoring service, how it works. And by the way, you can get monitoring service. So any brand coming into India, you can approach them and you can tell them, I'll do monitoring services for you for really low cost, whatever, and get started doing that. Rohit, is interning under boutique IP law firm like Anand and Anand better or full service law firm? So if you want to do IP, the best place should do IP are the boutique IP law firms and not the big law firms. In the big law firms, they have IP teams, but they are not doing the cutting edge work most of the time. And also in a big lawyers are like second class citizens. I'm sorry, but that's how it is. They get less salary. They have less say in the management. They are just there. Okay. In big law firms, the M&A lawyer is more valuable. The banking lawyer is more valuable. IP lawyers, I mean, this is my experience. I have seen IP lawyers are not treated as equals in big law firms. I'll recommend if you want to do IP, you have really good work in IP, go to boutique IP law firm. Anand Anand is a great place for that, right? Sai Krishna is a great place for that. But if you want to do IP law, don't go to big law firms. Okay, anybody else? I got a matter of contracts or sponsorship, equity share in franchise or cricket teams. Is IP important here? Of course, Sumit, it is everything. Like in any sports industry, sports and entertainment, IP is like everything. Without IP, there's no money, right? Movies make more money. A famous movie might make more money from the merchandising deals, where basically using the movie's brand, you sell pencil box and t-shirts and whatnot. That may make more money than the movie tickets, okay? Same for cricket. Like, how does any cricket team make money? They make money from, not from the viewing rights as much, they make from selling merchandise. Okay, so you can pitch a service to them that I will do a monitoring service for your team. We'll make sure that anything that happens, we will sue people, and this is how we'll make money, this is how it will benefit you, etc. Figure that out. Okay, okay. Anybody else? Anything else I can help with? I'm still here, but if there's nothing else, then I'll take you leave. Okay, it seems we are done. Thank you, everybody, for joining me on a Sunday afternoon. Great talking to you all. Do share with me what is the career next you want to talk about, and what are your questions that I can help in future with. I would really appreciate if you can tell me out of 0 to 10, how much will you give me for this session? 10 being really good, 0 being really bad. How much would you rate this session? 10 on 10. Thank you. A lecture on arbitration. Okay. Thank you, Gaurav. 10 on 10. Anybody else? Srivastava 9. Okay. All right. Great. Thanks, guys. Take care. Insurance law. Okay. We'll talk about insurance law soon. Private equity and everything. Okay. I will. Okay. All right. Thanks, guys. Take care. Have a great weekend. Have a great Sunday. Enjoy yourself. Take care. Bye.